and then extensions, replacements of plants, and you see that these are the big numbers, and they don't coordinate either with the empirical experience, which is an average of 4 or 5 per year, nor with any economic reality. I know how it works. I've been working on this since 2010, and it's always the same exercise, and I'm very glad to report that with a team of Berlin economists, we're currently doing the 21st century exercise, which is 100% renewables. And the only question is how the 100% renewables should be produced. Is it more central? Is it more decentral? Do you need more networks? Do you need cells in which they can be produced? So in the spring of 2019, we're happy to present the study probably here in Brussels and get over this nuclear paradox. Now, there's another aspect to nuclear power that has not been mentioned so far, but if you think back to 1945, the 16th of July, then you know that nuclear power has this second aspect, which is the military aspect, right? Think of early August, think of the reasons why nuclear power was generated. So even though we talk about transformation scenarios here and the economics, we must not forget that there are very important issues related in Europe and also in other regions, namely Russia and the United States, that affect us, and that's of course the INF treaty and the future of this. with the current decisions, there's no longer a legal basis for Europe to challenge Russia, for example, and perhaps also the United States, on producing and deploying INF range missiles, whether they be called SSC-8 or 9M7029, is an issue. Cohesion is critical as we go to elections in Europe. Some countries being NATO members, others not. Some countries being closer to the United States. Some countries being in direct conflict within the Union. And so the hope is, of course, that the INF be rehabilitated, that China enters the area, and that we won't, when we go on vacation, when I go on vacation in France, I always pass by Büchel, because that's the closest route, it's the most beautiful route, and it's not a very good feeling to have nuclear bombs stationed there. Let me come to the long-term task here. These are, of course, economics. The military aspects are short-term tasks. The long-term task is one that has been ignored for a long time. And as we say at our chair, often need to repeat what Claude has said, we have won, wir haben gewonnen. On the economic front, there's no doubt about the uneconomicness of nuclear power, but we need to start to work on the waste issue. Wir müssen jetzt anfangen zu arbeiten. Some of you may have heard this before. Fortunately, the responsibility for this goes to Professor Töpfer, but let me introduce the exercise, and I want to acknowledge those who have really worked on this, which are Ian Fairley, Gordon McCarron, who should have been here actually today, Ben, Arne Jungjahn, Anna Thormann, who have done this exercise of editing the first glimpse that I want to report on here, and that we'll discuss about most of us tomorrow. So it's an exercise of taking stock, normalizing data within Europe, which is very difficult, and pointing the finger into one issue that has been ignored for a very long time, including by my father, by the way. If I ask my father, why didn't you in the 60s care about this in your liberal party? No, we thought we'd just throw this in the ocean or didn't think about it at all, right? This is an issue for the for the 21st or probably 22nd or probably 23rd century if we take the case of Germany, which is currently discussing, and we'll hear about this more, which may start constructing in the 2030s, which may start disposing in the 2050s, and which may seal the site in the early 22nd century. We need to have money for doing this. So a challenge is how to finance the waste issue, and we need to produce it. This is an often ignored question. You need companies, you need incentives, you need technical knowledge, you need people. And so I think as we restart this process, there are different organizational models, and we'll probably discuss this a little later. The question whether this needs to be done by the state or by private companies incited by some regulator. In Germany, the process has been going from the money being spent, being put aside by the companies to a state fund and a state managed process. We have similar questions related to the decommissioning process, which also be more expensive and more complicated as we think. Now, the glimpse that Rebecca Harmt referred to is on the complexity of the issue. Nothing is easy in Europe. Nothing is easy in Belgium. Nothing is easy anywhere. But try to come up with data on the issue of waste storage in Europe, and you'll have very different categories. And as every country has its own tradition, engineers, etc., there's not a single unified measure of these. But of course, the high-level waste is the most important. The heat-generating waste is the most important, and within the EU, almost no country has adhered to the EU standards that have been set. Nonetheless, the authors that I've mentioned have done this exercise to come up with data, and there's huge amount of volumes and of tonnage for the waste issue. Of course, two countries are leading this, United Kingdom and France, who have together more than two-thirds of the entire volumes. Low level, medium level, very important, Konrad, etc. But of course, the main issue, and this is where you come from, Ms. Harms, Golem, is that the high level waste, the spent fuel waste. I tell you a little anecdote, because for a couple of years now, I'm traveling to Golem whenever I can. We did a bike ride the other day, and I asked my son, our son, to come with me, and he said, Golem? Never heard about this. He's born in 2000. We should go there. I said, oh, this is important. You will pay for this. No, I won't pay for it. We went there, we spoke to people, and afterwards I said, hey, Jesus Christ, Daddy, what did you do to my generation? I said, this is my father's generation. Actually, last week, Ben took his students to Golem, and will continue to do this because it's an important event. Russia, of course, has still more. 2022, this is now in thousands of tons. France, Germany, this is a total of 56,000 tons high spent fuel, highly radioactive waste that needs to be disposed. As we know, there is no disposal site currently. Finland is kind of progressing slowly. Sweden has just stopped its process. We don't know whether the copper will hold. We'll hear about Germany in a second. We went to the States. As I said, Yucca Mountain is probably dead. We proposed another site, the WIP site, which is down in the south, and people told us, you're crazy. we will publish it academically nonetheless, but there's no issue to this currently. There's an issue about processing radioactive waste, which in some countries is treated as an asset, strangely. So it must not, in that case, it's not treated as a waste, but it's an asset. We know that this can reduce the volume, but it's expensive, it's dangerous, there's risk of proliferation there, and so there's no way of using this as a solution. And then, of course, we must not forget the long-term aspects of this. We're not talking about 10,000 years, we're talking about hundreds, thousands of years, and solutions that need to be found. And so within the next 3 months, I guess this report should be finished. It's a kickoff report. I'm looking forward to the final version as well, and I'm looking forward to discussing with you, with everybody here, on an issue which is very important and which is inseparable from other issues on nuclear power. Thank you very much, and I look forward to the further discussions.
So, and now miracles happen. Our guest, Mr. Töpfer, will be the next speaker. I say miracles happen because when we met for the first time, he was the Minister for Environment. I was one of the presidents of the local citizens group fighting against Gorleben. When we met for the first time, I think both of us would not have thought that not years, but decades later, we would meet again and both trying to contribute to a real and acceptable, sustainable solution for the waste problem, the nuclear waste problem. Mr. Töpfer is right now leading a group which is called Das Nationale Begleitgremium. So it's very difficult to translate. Maybe you have a perfect translation. But it's a group also led by Mr. Töpfer and a professor who is expert on participation processes. It's so this new exercise of participation, which shall change the new search for a disposal site fundamentally and make it successful. Please, Mr. Töpfer, explain us the new start in Germany.
Good evening. Thank you very much for inviting me. I join those who were not quite a long time anymore in Brussels. Maybe it is recommendable to avoid Brussels. Maybe. But I don't want to be too direct critical. No, listening always the evening, I'm considering to quote one of the German humoristic person, entertainer, I'll name him. He once mentioned, everything is already said, but not yet by everybody. So I'm the last one. And that is by itself wonderful to learn, because all those different wordings, from mole to whatever you have said, was linked with me. I'm one of those loser, or what? I was responsible more than 8 years as a Minister for Environment, Nature Protection and Nuclear Power. I was the doer. And I was at the end the head of what we called the ASIC Commission after the disaster of Fukushima, 2011. And this was the ASIC Commission to single out what shall Germany do? Are we going on with nuclear, or do we have a decision to go out? Only to remember, only a little bit more than half a year before, the German government under Angela Merkel decided to postpone the end time quite drastically. And now this happened. There was a question what to do. And to some extent, it is a development which is not only positive, that whenever ever we have something to decide in politics with some problems, we decide now to have a commission. We never in Germany had so many commissions in one coalition agreement as we have it now. And that is to some extent a disaster for politics. I could discuss this the whole evening. So I'm not proud to be a head of a commission. Because there was, of needless to say, the discussion that is already decided, but the chancellor didn't want to do it, and there are some others, and then she asked Töpfer, he was in the cabinet when she was in the cabinet as well. So we got another one. We were two chair, and the other one was the president of the German Forschungsgemeinschaft, Professor Matthias Kleiner, a good friend in the meantime of mine. He is now responsible for Leibniz Institutes. And we were together with 17 people, and our main decision in the very beginning was, if we try to single out winners and losers, we will never come to a reliable discussion and solution for the future. I can only recommend to be careful with those wordings. It is not a disaster that somebody changed his mind, by the way. It is not, it shall even happen with new information. I only want to mention this. And we decided, all those 17, unanimously, that Germany is able to phase out nuclear. We had, of course, side conditions for that. One was, please don't close your nuclear power plants and import nuclear power from your neighbors. We were also convinced, don't close the nuclear power plants and increase your production of electricity via coal. We were also convinced, don't close your nuclear power plants with an enormous effect on the price situation that the German industry is not competitive anymore. Only three, we had altogether five. So this was necessary. And it was also necessary to consider what are we going to do in 2022, the last nuclear power plant in Germany will be shut down, the last one. These, we have this only to remember, it is 2019, 20, 21, 22. That's it. So now we have, of course, to dismantle and we have waste. Of course, it could be a good idea for one or the other to say, that comes much later. So don't care about it. That was not done. There were at least three main questions to solve. The first was, what is the way to find a location for the handling of the nuclear waste? And you know, we are absolutely sure there will be most probably not a single location in Germany, quite densely populated, where the people are happy if we inform them that there will be the waste disposal site. It is not only a technical topic, it is also a psychological topic. It's a topic to bring people in the discussion. Of course, you can come back and say, we didn't do it, let others do it. But at the end of the day, we had also decided this waste has to be handled, finally handled, in Germany. This is quite a decision. Because we have also to consider that other people have most probably other problems. Germany is a fairly bigger country, but we have also in Europe smaller countries. How can we handle this? I only want to make this footnote that this seems to be unquestionable positive, but we must have an eye on this also from the European way and to question what is going on. But if a country like Germany starts with not here but others, then you can forget it. And therefore, it was absolutely necessary to make this decision as well. Then it was necessary, who is financing this all? You know, sustainability means always the decision, what is the externality part. If you have low costs, I'm never convinced that this can make a contribution, because the costs are reflecting what you integrate in your calculation. If you integrate in your calculation all the indirect costs later, then that's another price. All this is intensively discussed. The World Foundation makes lots of big books and others about that. But we know it will be quite a challenging financial topic. So we got one commission with Mr. Trittin as one of the main chair to decide the financial term. And they came to the conclusion that the work to handle waste will be go to the public, and the money will go to the public as well. So they made a foundation, and in the foundation they invested from the private companies, after a long discussion, 24 billion euros. We know that this will not be enough to handle this job. So there is also an externality, but there was a need to be aware that if you take all this in the private bill, you will have a shock in the German economy, and this was not recommendable. So they made the finance. I made it only with one word. This is much more difficult. But altogether, 24 billion are there. But we are all convinced that maybe not enough. Second, it was clear we must make a process totally new with regard to psychological topic of this, what I mentioned in the beginning. So the structure now is, and luckily I'm a person without slides. I don't start this anymore. I'm now 80 years plus, so don't start with slides with me. Maybe you can also listen, and that would be also fine enough. Slides is not my business. Wonderful slides here, by the way. Wonderful, wonderful. I'm always fascinating, but you must also know your limits. Yeah? That's for me. It's for me. Anyhow, it was necessary the normal way of handling such a topic. You must have a partner who asks for the permission to do something on a specific place. You must have an organization, a public organization, who is deciding whether this can be allowed or not. This is a normality, and that we have as well. But both of those, the institution who is licensing and the company who is asking for doing this, are both publicly owned. We sincerely hope that this will not be a problem in the future. But they are now also financed via the taxpayer. This is a normality. But they were all convinced in this specific case, we must have a new idea how to integrate the broader public in this decision-making process. We cannot do in the normality that somebody is asking for an ounce, they do it, and then we are integrating the private sector. That is not the case. So they decided to have a new institution. I tried to translate it. It's very difficult. The federal, also we are the, wait a moment. We are the organization for the broader participation for handling nuclear waste. In German, it is such a long word that nobody is mentioning it. So I'm a chairman of the Nationalen Begleitgremium für die Entsorgung hochradioaktiver Abfallstoffe. Try to translate it correctly, and then please come back. See, also this is a topic. This group will have altogether 18 members. one-third of those are what we called the citizen by chance. They are selected in a random process so that we hope that we will even change our language. You see, we had just on last Saturday a conference on the new geodata law. If you listen to all of those, nobody can understand this. And if you cannot understand this, you cannot expect that they trust you. But how to de-armament your language? I think it is a challenge for each and everybody. And therefore, it is helpful to have some people with you who are asking questions, what, by the way, is that meaning? And we have to explain it, and we have to do it in a way to reduce complexity without lying. Whenever you reduce complexity, you exclude some information. It's a very challenging topic. How to make a language understandable without being criticized for not saying the full truth. And I would really challenge all of you to consider a little bit these topics, because what we have in Germany may be a specific, sensitive and nervous public, but be sure, wherever you come and will bring waste to this, you will have some critical and nervous people as well. And therefore, and that is good, and that's fine, because that is also pressing and asking for deeper and deeper discussion of the topics. So we try to have those six people. One is a housewife, and two of those six have to be member of the young generation. So I'm not this member. The other shall be respected person in public life. Now you will. That is, of course, very difficult to say no if somebody asks you to do something like this. We are always a little bit linked with, in other cases, they say that are ombudspersons. We don't like this so very much. We want to be integrated in the broader public and bring the people in the very beginning already to this. So we make these meetings when a law is under preparation, not when it is finalized. We want to be in the beginning with all the information possible. So our need is participatory, it is knowledge-based, it is transparent, and it is a procedure which is self-questioning again and again. And we are entitled also to make a feedback if this seems to be necessary. And we underline again and again that we are not at all linked to a specific timetable. There shall be, that's the main of the new law, there should be a decision on the location in 2031. We always mention we make a decision when the decision is integrated in the broader public and not the other way around. If you start with the time first and then say, you will not succeed. If you go first and say, we want to make all your question a real topic, then we can come back and say that is the result of all this and we can do it in year X or Y. So altogether, it is quite something, especially also now visible what it is a reaction. A lot of time is necessary for doing something like this. And we are honorable persons only, also no money or whatever. So one of our by chance member just resigned because it's too much work for him. Per week, 11 hours he calculated, and that was too much for an independent person. You can understand it. So you have again to balance whatever you want. So those who have time may be not the by chance citizen, and all this is to make a new possibility. We also are convinced, only to echo a little bit what was mentioned before, I know 9 o'clock is reception. And if you come from Freiburg with ECE and Thales, you have all the good reasons for asking for a good ring, by the way. But I was told that it is impossible to bring it here. So, because I mentioned a good ring. Anyhow, only to add a little bit those topics, we decided in the law, in the basic law for the handling of waste, that we start with a white map. Everything is possible. The new coalition agreement in Bavaria. Bavaria had no nuclear power plant ever. As you know, in this coalition agreement, it is mentioned that Bavaria is, of course, not a location for handling waste. If we start this, you can imagine that others are doing the same. And then we are back. So we have to react, and we reacted, and we will do it in other cases as well. A white map. Of course, there are specific nature possibilities, rock salt, claystone, and crystalline structures. That is a little bit the surprise for the one or the other, because that goes also to Saxonia and Bavaria, and that is a hard topic to do. Anyhow, that only to make it there. We also are convinced that we must decide what is the retrievability of this. What is that? You see, if you have in the law, the recommendation, not the decision, that you are responsible for 1 million years, then you must ask also the question, maybe in 1 million years people can learn the one or the other as a topic, or can something happen what we couldn't expect that it happened? So how to handle the retrievability? By the way, that is also one of the topics which is echoing to those who are asking, are there technologies to expect who can reduce the intensity of the nuclear waste capacities? So this mold topic is very well known for myself, because I had the chance to be a founder of a new Institute of Advanced Sustainability Studies in Potsdam. And one of the directors with me was Carlo Rubbia. Carlo Rubbia is a Nobel Prize laureate, also even older than I am. And he is the person who was handling those topics. Therefore, we are calling this the Rubatron, Rubbia's topic. He is not any longer really integrated in this. But of course, we have to have an eye on this. So in the law, it is also mentioned that at least for 500 years after concluding the construction and the filling of the waste, you must have a chance to bring it back if something is happening what you couldn't know before. Hard to discuss, but I think necessary to mention. Finally, this law, and those topics is much more complicated, of course, but I want to make you a little bit interested to read more about this. This was accepted not only by the two coalition partners, not only by the CDU and the SPD and the CSU, but it was also accepted and very intensively worked out by the Greens. Very, very true. I'm not sure why the left party did not agree. They are very close to the same topic. Needless to say that others are convinced that nuclear waste is a challenge for a good life later. We have not to do anything about that. But if you wait for those people, then you wait always for stupid, stupid reactions. Take it all together, you know, we are only 2.5 years old. You are selected for 3 years, but you can be prolongated for three times 3 years, so 9 years. So if I would do that, that I would be at the end 90 years old. If they give me the guarantee that I reach 90, then I do it. But nobody does it, and therefore I think younger people have to come as well. I thank you very much.
To conclude, round about 45 years after the decision was made to bring all the nuclear waste of Germany into my home region, into this village Gorleben, 45 years later, we are back at point zero. We are restarting the process. Some people are doubting it. Some people in Germany, also in my region, still think that Gorleben will be again the final destination of the process. I trust in reasonability, and I trust also in the possibilities to enter new processes, new debates, and to open perspectives. But again, so my generation will pass the ball, will pass the task to the next generation, and probably the next generation will pass the challenges to the next ones. So we are working on the report before the end of the legislation. We hope to be able to present here in Brussels a reference report on the situation with nuclear waste, including some country examples, country reports, in a way that for the first time it would be able, it would be possible to really compare the information you get about the one country with the information you get about the other country. So thanks for everybody who will contribute. And now I wish you a nice reception, and I wish also Mr. Töpfer that he likes the drink we are offering. See you later.